Every day I've got about an hour and 15 drive from my hometown Kristiansund to Molde before training.
Always have a nice chat with this man in the morning. You've got to get them at it this morning. You've got to get them at it. Nå kommer de på TV.
Hey.
That was built about 20 years ago, this bridge, I remember. I just had my driver's license. And it makes it easier so that we don't have to go over the ferry, which is just over there. Lonely driving, but then again, it's a time that I enjoy, because I enjoy to prepare and it gets your time into training you and into games to think about tactics and what we're going to do today. And on the way back home, you evaluate and you finish football. So when I'm back home, I don't have to think too much about football. Being called a gaffer is that's of course strange when you think about the origin of it, because that's the old fella, and of course my two coaches are older than me, but still I'm in charge, so that they use that name. I know that the people at United are aware of how we're doing. I think the managers following all his ex-players and how they do with the coaching, and he's got a great record of making players into managers. I'm 100% sure that his way of managing rubs off on his players. Me and the gaffer, we had a very good relationship, but it wasn't like a everyday chat relationship. He left me to it, and I trusted him to manage my career. So when I left, he just he gave me a few advice that I've written down and I'm going to keep to myself, of course. He just said, you know where I am, you know, you've got my number, and I don't want to waste his time too much. I don't want to call him all the time. I know how busy he is as well. But if it comes to a point where I really struggle and need some advice, I'll call him, because you know you'll get the best advice.
I've often thought about how would a manager react if we were in this situation. We lost 5-0 to one of the bottom teams at the time. Away from home, we got battered. It reminded me of when we lost to Newcastle 5-0 in 96, my first season, and how he reacted then was, for me, just an inspiration as a player. And then now I've used the same technique and style for my players, and it seemed to work, because he did trust us and I trust my players. When I got this job, there was expected of us that we'd win the league straight away, but I didn't really put the pressure on myself or the coaching staff that we'll have to win it the first season. Having been a successful player makes you relax a little bit. Now I'm trying a new career, and yeah, you do everything you can to be successful, but if you fail, you fail. But as long as I do it my way, I'm sure whatever the results, I would be happy with myself. I don't really put that much of pressure on us winning the league all the time, not yet.
We'll be right back.
teams coming to the stadium, defending in numbers, 11 men behind the ball, and making it difficult. So that's something we've got to get used to. We didn't score, and that's the thing that hurts me a little bit, that we don't score them in the good chances we have. And I've been in this situation before at Man United. It's not supposed to be easy, and 4 games to go.
Hi again, welcome back. We won the league, and now I'm the proud manager of the champions. So, very, very, very pleased with the season. Despite drawing quite a few games towards the end, not picking up too many points, our cushion was big enough, and luckily Rosenborg, Tromsø, the other teams didn't catch us, so 2 games to go and we're champions. I've got loads of champagne bottles here that we've got to have to give to the players. So I've still not opened it. So that's actually, we've got this MFK, 100 years, first trophy. And after our last draw at home, where we could have won it ourselves, watching the game, Rosenborg Brann on telly after, where they lost, that was quite nerve-wracking. But when they lose at home, 6-3, we can all go out and celebrate. That was a fantastic night. It was a fantastic atmosphere in the dressing room, as you might imagine. I think that the scenes of Molde Town would be similar to Deansgate of 99 after the Champions League. It was like a big sea of people and everyone cheering. Of course, I had a couple of beers and great atmosphere. The thing when you win a league as a manager compared to a player is that you feel for all the other people, especially my captain, who's been at the club since he was 6 probably, or maybe even 4. He's been there 30 years. He's always been a number 2. They've lost. He's had 5 silver medals, and for him to finally win it was, yeah, a little bit emotional. Not for myself, but for him, a great day. So all that's left now for us to do is to play the last home game, get the medals, get the proof that we won the league this year, and really enjoy and celebrate that night. First of all, we're going to give it a good go. Hopefully we can win the game for the supporters as well, because I think that's important. We should go out there and attack and score a few goals.
For 3 weeks now, the party has gone on. We are celebrating in three weeks.
And it will still be until New Year's Eve.
Yeah. Last night, it was a lot of celebrating. It was very late and it was free drinks, so terrible.
Free drinks for a Norwegian, that means a very, very tight head the next day.
The gold medal is delivered out and the whole city is celebrating.
This is the first time for Molde, so now we're going to be like United and win it every year.
You should look at my new shoes, they are from gold. Made of gold. Maybe. He has made all the effort to make it happen in the most important year ever for us.
Just maybe we made it. Sing like you want it.
praise for the manager because he deserves it, and Mark. And it's a great feeling.
I've been warned about ex-Man United players going away, being manager, and having success the first year, and then not doing so well the years after. So it's not going to be I'm not going to rest on my laurels, that's for sure. I'm going to work harder than ever to try to get this feeling again.
It's an unbelievable achievement what he's done this year. His first job in management, the pressure of being such a superstar in Norway, which he is.